Vintage computers are getting hotter by the year. So here's another 10 that you might want to grab today. Welcome to Billboard. Since my last video on the top 10 collectible computers, interest in vintage computers has increased even further. In fact, some of the computers are fetching higher prices than I suggested only 6 months ago. And some of the comments you left suggest that prices do vary wildly in different parts of the world. So in this video, I'm not going to suggest prices, except to say that at the time of making this video, all of the computers in this top 10 should be reasonably affordable for even someone new to collecting vintage computers. Except for maybe number one. So let's get straight into another 10 collectible computers to look out for. At number 10, the Osborne 1. The Osborne 1 was one of the first portable computers, but anyone who's ever lifted one in real life will tell you they are more luggable than portable. Having said that, you could easily fold up the keyboard and take this thing with you, which was very impressive at the time. The Osborne 1 had a tiny CRT screen, which was surprisingly usable. In the business world, these machines were extremely popular for using tools like WordStar and other business applications. I should mention though that these machines are not for the faint-hearted. They can have issues with component failures, and there are videos on YouTube with collectors showing unexpected smoke rising from their machines. And they really are large and heavy and will be expensive to ship and not easy to display. But the tiny CRT will be enough to impress anyone that's never seen one before. At number 9, the Atari 800 XL. Atari has always been synonymous with video games, but they're not as widely known for their computers. And as you would expect, their 8-bit line of computers had an interesting history with an initial release of an Atari 400 and Atari 800 in 1979. The Atari 800 XL was released in 1983 and was intended to go up against the Commodore 64 and the Tandy Coco, and went on to become Atari's best-selling computer at the time. And like many computers on this list, the Atari is a great way to introduce yourself or your family to basic programming, which is a breeze on these older machines as the programming language is built in. A talking point amongst collectors and non-collectors, an Atari 8-bit computer is always a worthwhile investment. Number 8, the TRS-80 Color Computer. The TRS-80 Color Computer, or COCO as it's affectionately known, was an odd little beast as it had a completely different Motorola 609E processor, as opposed to the traditional Z80 processor, which partly defined the name of the TRS-80s that came before it. Amongst computer collectors, the COCOs are not super popular, which means the prices are relatively low, at least for now. As I've stated before, the underdog status will be something that actually makes these computers more collectible in the future. Number 7, the Commodore 64 Breadbin. The Commodore 64 is one of the most well-known and well-loved 80s home computers. Many 80s kids would say the C64 defined their childhood. The range of software available for the Commodore 64 is vast, and the level of support out there is incredible. Now, you may notice that I've specifically called out the Breadbin model. This is because it is the most iconic version of the Commodore 64, and this shows in the value of machines available in the wild. One thing to note about the older C64s is the power supplies can have issues. So make sure you do your research before diving into the vintage Commodore 64 world. Number 6, the Dick Smith VZ300. So in my last list, I included the Dick Smith VZ200, which was an awesome little machine with a cult following. So I can promise you that the VZ300 is another machine guaranteed to be a future collectible. The VZ300 looks a lot like its predecessor, but has been enhanced with features such as a better keyboard and other better specs. Both the VZ200 and VZ300 were rebadged VTech laser machines, so there is a range of software and enthusiast support available across the world. A great machine with great features that doesn't take up a lot of space. Number 5, the BBC Micro. Everyone loves a good bit of British retro. And nothing is more British than the BBC Micro. I mean, it was commissioned by the BBC itself as part of the BBC Computer Literacy Project in the 1980s. And if you haven't seen the BBC TV series The Computer Programme with Ian McNaught Davis, there is a link below in the description. It's a wonderful, nostalgic journey, and there is still plenty of educational value. The Beeb, as it was known, was super popular in the UK and prolific in the British school system. The computer itself was built by the Acorn Computer Company and had the popular 6502 processor. Obviously, you're more likely to find these computers in the UK, but they are also scattered around the globe. They're a solid little machine, very recognisable, and will be a great addition to anyone's vintage computer collection. Number 4. The Amstrad PPC 512. Anyone who's seen the 2004 movie Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind would be familiar with this computer's use in erasing a human's mind. Actually, the technology in that movie was fictional, and my research also suggested the computer may have been a PPC 640, but who's counting? Anyway, the computers are super cool and have an awesome looking LCD screen that flips up. These are the first portable IBM PC compatible computers made by Amstrad, and I guarantee these things will become more and more sought after, so get one while you can. Number 3. Apple Macintosh Plus. Nothing says retro Macintosh like the iconic shape of the Apple Macintosh Plus. Unless you're a Macintosh aficionado, you may find it difficult to tell at a glance which model this is. The Macintosh Plus is seen as the third generation Macintosh and was introduced in 1986. The Mac Plus was the first Macintosh to introduce SCSI ports as a standard way to connect external peripherals such as hard drives, CD-ROMs and other external storage. The Plus also introduced the newer double capacity 800K floppy drives. It is always fun to see how many YouTube creators will have some kind of Macintosh that looks like this in their background of their videos. So grabbing one of these is a great way to get into collectible Macintoshes. One thing to note is that they did have overheating issues, so are more likely to have failures due to dried out solder joints and other component issues. Even if you get a broken one, you could still make it into a plant pot and it will still look cool. Number 2. The Sinclair ZX80. The Sinclair ZX80 is the baby Yoda of collectible computers. I mean, just look how cute it is. Another retro machine from the shores of Great Britain, the ZX80 was released in 1980 and was priced at the time of less than £100, which made it quite an affordable way to get into this newfangled world of computers. And these were an unusual little machine in that you may have noticed the commands above the letters on the keyboard. This is because of the unique way of programming, which was not by typing but selecting commands. The machine was also quite unique in the way that it could not display video unless it was not doing anything else. Do some research and you'll see this machine is one of a kind. And it's that uniqueness that I think will continue to make this a much sought after device. And because it's so small, it will sit nicely on your shelf for people to admire. Number 1. The IBM 5150. Ferris Bueller had one. Van Halen named an album after one. So for those reasons alone, the IBM 5150 is number 1 on my list. Okay, so there are other reasons. The 5150 is basically the first of the IBM PC line of computers. The IBM universe prior to the PC was more about big business machines, including mainframes and other beasts. The personal computer market at the time was basically Apple, Tandy and Commodore. The 5150 was developed in secret in Florida and was finally released in 1981 with Charlie Chaplin being the mascot for the machine. The 5150 was a big success with orders running out the door and a large software base was quickly developed for it. If you are considering getting one, they are one of those machines that might need some TLC, such as recapping to prevent smoking and popping capacitors. But components should be relatively easy to come by. These things will look amazing in your collection and have a very dominating appearance. And you will be part of a very supportive group of fans of this machine. Anyone who's anyone in the retro computing fraternity owns one of these. Prices are starting to climb, so if you do see one out there for a reasonable price, I say grab it, quick. So what did you think of this list? Do you have any of these beautiful machines? Do you think you would sell to cash in, or are you passionate about collecting? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, my next video list will be about the more rare vintage computers to watch out for. So please hit subscribe so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching. Wrong.